Good morrow, people of the internet, and welcome back, finally. It's been a while, to Phoenix Wright. I am excited to get back into this. I love this game so much. Let's not hesitate. Let's get right into it. Mr. Wright, you are amazing in there. Really? I think I might be your newest fan. Oh, I was just doing my job, you know. Then again, that other attorney was pretty cool too. Huh? That face of his, with his eyes wide, trembling lips, it sent shivers up my spine.
You say so.
So, what happens with me? Do I get to go home now? Well, no. I don't think so. Not yet.
Oh, I see.
But I got a great lead in today's trial.
A lead?
The man with Miss May. He's the key.
Oh, I get it. What happens to Miss May after that anyway?
I heard they arrested her. I guess she's learning her charms won't work everywhere. She's probably at the detention center now. I may have to go down there later. Anyway, this case is far from closed.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to find out more about this man.
Do you think he was the one who...
Maybe so.
Sis?
Don't worry. I'll find him by tomorrow, I promise.
I'm counting on you.
Alright. More detective work. I'll ask for a full record of Miss April May's testimony. I thought it might come in handy during the trial tomorrow. But now that I have it, I'm not so sure. Most of her testimony was all lies. In fact, there's only one part that got left on the record. May testimony added to the court record. I don't know how much good this will do me at all now. Anyway, time to hit the pavement and do some investigating. Maya doesn't belong in that detention center, and it's up to me to get her free.
To be continued. Although we're going to continue it right now.
Sure, thanks, game. Whatever. Let's just carry on.
September 7th, 3:11 p.m. Detention Center, Visitor's Room.
Well, hello! I didn't expect anyone to visit me in such a dank place like this.
Ha, 420.
It's really quite moving.
Not you, stinking lawyer. I hope you die. Have you come to laugh? Yes, laugh at the fallen Miss May.
No, not really. There's something I wanted to ask.
Unfortunately, there is nothing I want to be asked.
Haven't you done enough questioning, you spiky head?
Here we go again. Please, you're scaring the security guard.
So, what is it you wish to ask me then,
For starters, how did you get to be so totally whacked?
I should talk.
That man. Oh, the man who stayed with you in your hotel room. Can you tell me more about him? Where is he? Come on.
No way, Jose.
Jose. Oh no. Maybe I had something to get at. Talk.
The wiretap.
Why did you place a wiretap in May's phone?
When you say it like that, it sounds so cold. So criminal.
Tapping people's phones is a crime, Miss May.
Oh, and I suppose you learned that in lawyer school, Creep.
This woman is impossible to talk to.
Your attitude.
Say, why are you so angry? I mean, you don't look like a bad person.
Oh, that does it, bottom-feeding scum-sucking lawyer.
Bottom? I can't tell. Does she have the thing against lawyers, or just against me?
Alright, present. Do we have any evidence? Probably not good, is it? Maybe this?
Hey, guess what? Actually, I really hate your guts, so get lost, because, well, I'm not cooperating.
Thanks, I notice. Well, this, May's testimony. Oh, I guess she's gonna say the same thing over and over again. Alright. And I guess we're just gonna have to move. Court record? No, we already picked that. Alright, guess we're gonna have to move. Where to move?
Fanco Law Offices, Gatewater Hotel, Osberg Law Offices. Let's go to Fanco Law Offices.
September 7th, Fanco Law Offices. Looks like forensics is taking the day off. Detective Gunshoe's nowhere in sight. Police really gave this place a working over. I doubt there are any valuables left. Valuable clues. I can't speak today. Suppose it can't hurt to take a look around, though. Examine. So, don't think there's much to examine. It's a plant. Let's examine this plant. Mia's favorite pot of plant. I guess I'll have to water it now. Back. Can we move around a bit? Well, no, we can't move at all. No, guess can't do much. Examine. Let's look at the windows. Sky is blue, and so am I. That's the hotel, right across the way. Maybe we should go to the hotel. That's the court record. Move. And to the hotel. September 7th, Gatewater Hotel, room 303.
Ah, welcome, sir. Quite the performance today, if I dare say so myself.
Thanks. Sorry for putting you on the spot like that.
No, not at all, sir. Your efforts taken only help the Gatewater's rep, as they say.
Huh? Rep?
Yes, our reputation will swell as the hotel where the murder used a wiretap, as the hotel where... We can charge a premium for the room. Of course, it'll be great for business, sir.
Whoa! Miss May hasn't been charged with murder.
I too will become famous, the bellboy who brought the murderer iced coffee.
Why do I feel like we're both stuck in the same bad dream?
So, you are honored guest. Please let me know if there is anything I can bring you.
Maybe we should talk to him. Miss May. About Miss May.
Oh, her? Sir, not to boast, but I knew the moment I saw her.
She'd do it, I said.
Do what?
Starting to think the most suspicious person here is this guy. The man with Miss May. I wanted to ask you about the man who is with Miss May.
Ah, yes. He struck me as a real lady killer, if you pardon the expression. I knew it from the moment I saw him, sir. He and I are the same ilk. We both carry the scent of danger.
There we are, in total agreement, Mr. Psycho Bellboy.
If you had a photo of that man, I'm quite sure I could identify him.
A photo? The hotel. Could you tell me about this hotel?
Absolutely, and on that subject, I have an excellent idea, sir. Currently, this hotel is known as the Gatewater. I propose that we add a subtitle.
A subtitle?
The Gatewater Hotel.
Murder Manor.
Well, what do you think?
Sounds great. Whatever floats your tea, sir. Present? I don't know. Can we present May's autopsy report? Present the wiretap.
I'm sorry. All I could think about during the trial was the hotel. I wasn't paying much attention to evidence.
Okay, you're not much help then. Let's move. Where to? Rosberg Law Offices, I guess.
September 7th. Grossberg Law Offices.
Huh. Looks like Grossberg is out today. Again. He's avoiding me for some reason. Look around the room. Couldn't hurt. What's that? What's this? Old photos. There are two lying here. Something's been written on pencil in the backs. DL6 incident. Exhibit A. DL6 incident. Exhibit B. Let's take a look at these. I'm sure I've seen this person somewhere. Perhaps I'll borrow this photo. I'm sure no one will miss just one little photo. And it might be a valuable clue. I'll take it for now. Brookworth quite quietly added to the court record. Oh, come on, right? There's another one there. Photo lies on the desk. Maybe I should switch it with the one I took?
Sure. Let's swap this. So I have a sneaky suspicion. This is a man. Maybe I've got something here. We could go to, back to the hotel, show him this photo, and then he might, because he said he'd definitely identify him. Okay, present. If we present this photo,
Take a look at this photo.
That's him, Detective!
I'm the lawyer. Oh, I know that. I just wanted to say, Detective once. You know how it is. No, I don't.
Without a doubt, that is the man who checked in with Miss April May. How about I write an affidavit swearing that it's him?
An affidavit? This guy is way too excited about this.
Sure.
Well, sure. Why not?
Yes! I've always wanted to write an affidavit, sir. From henceforth, I will be known as the bellboy who swore the affidavit.
Just hurry up and write it. Bellboy's affidavit added to the court record. That can't hurt. Not even Miss May can play dumb to this.
Right. Ooh.
Move. We can move to Gross Detention Center, that's what I mean.
You again? Can you take a hint and stay gone?
Hey, the only reason I'm back here is because you won't talk to me.
Oh, so it's my fault now? You don't just have spiky hair, you also have a spiky heart.
That does it. When this case is done, I'm shaving my head.
Present. Miss May, take a look at this.
Do you have a look at this?
What's that? The bellboy's
The bellboy's affidavit. He told us everything he saw. He told us about the man you checked in with.
He told us he was...
Now I'm getting somewhere. Push her hard.
This is it. All or nothing. Time to do a little bluff. No use playing dumb, if indeed that's an act.
If you don't talk, I'm taking this photo to the press.
What?
Even though he should be a witness to the murder, this man is in hiding, before the press would have a field day with his reputation.
Ugh, fine, I'll talk. You win, lawyer.
Yes! Man, that felt good. It's great to be alive.
Why are you pumping your fists in the air?
Now, tell me about the man you were with.
That man, he's my boss, Red White, the president of the information gathering conglomerate, Blue Corp.
Red White? Information gathering?
Well, I suppose you could call them a detective agency.
So this is the man that was with you the night of the murder?
I'm scared to talk. I don't want to end up like her.
That's okay. I'll just ask Mr. White himself. Can you tell me where Blue Corp is located? Mr. Red White. At last. Finally. A lead on this guy. If Ever May couldn't have done it, that leaves him. Time to take action. Discarded the bellboy's affidavit. So where is he? How about this photograph?
You're wasting your time. Miss May's lips are sealed.
Okay, where to then? Blue Corp, I guess. There we go.
Let's go!
September 7th, Blue Corp, Inc. CEO's office. What is the surreal decor?
Welcome! Please furnish me with the title of your personage.
What the?
Your name! What's your name? I would just inquiringly asking the title that you go by.
Wright. Phoenix Wright. Inquiringly?
Mr. Wright, is it? Wright, I see. Splendiferous! Perhaps I've intimidated you with my giantesque vocabulary.
What is this guy's problem?
I'm Red White, CEO of Blue Corp. You know, corporate expansion officer. My business dealings bring me into contact with the elite of the elite. So I'm afraid I'm not used to conversing with the worldly challenged.
Conversing, that's the word.
What a fruitcake! I thought that said something different there.
Huh, let me guess. You're an attorney fresh out of law school, are you not? That's the only explanation for why you would come to me like this.
What does he mean by that?
No matter. So, what business does a mighty lawyer have with a man such as myself?
Yikes. This guy's arrogance meter is off the scale.
Who talked to you, mate? Miss May.
Miss May is an employee of Blue...
Wrong voice. Miss May is an employee of Blue Corp, is she not?
Correct. She was my secretariat. What a shock it was to hear that what she has done.
What she has done? You mean the wiretap?
Indeed. She is paid to answer phones. Tapping them is not in her job description. She does gather information for us as part of her duties. But, I assure you, we do not condeal illegal methods. It is infallible that she would do this. Ineffable.
Sounds like he's trying to turn Miss May into a scapegoat.
On the matter,
why are you in April May's hotel room?
Who can say? I seldom pay attention to mundane details such as time and place. My motto is, don't worry, be happy. Still, Mr. White.
The hotel bellboy has stated on record that he does remember you very clearly.
No matter. The bellboy can say what he pleases. I still won't talk to you. If you want to speak, put me on the witness stand. Although, I doubt you'd be capable of doing that.
You raise a good question, actually. Why didn't prosecution call him as a witness? You'd have seen the same thing as April May.
The police, the courts. To me, they are mere toys, playthings for my amusement.
Blue Corp? What kind of company is Blue Corp anyway?
Ah, excellent question. We buy and sell various kinds of information. We are a company of the future. You might say we are the future.
Sell information?
In just 10 years, I've built this business up into the grand office you see now. In case you were wondering, Blue Corp was named after the color blue. Aye, Red White of Blue Corp, as I, founder and CEO, named it so. And why, you ask? Because I like the color blue, of course. Fantabulastic, is it not?
Sure. There's something that's been bothering me.
Yes, what might that be?
A big painting on the wall over there. It's gorgeous. I've seen it before. When did you get it?
Let's go with this gorgeous. Flaring.
Very striking piece of art.
Magnificent. That's
a word, isn't it?
Yeah.
Why am I making small talk? something that's been bothering me.
Yes? What might that be?
This big painting on the wall over there. Let's just ask every question. You know, I've actually seen that painting before.
Oh?
Just yesterday, actually.
Your point being?
My point is simple. Rather, my question is simple. Why is that painting hanging on your wall?
Mr. Wrong, was it?
Right.
It appears you do not fully grasp your position here. I asked again, who are you?
A lawyer?
No, my feeble friend, a mere lawyer. Worth nothing, zilch, zippo, nada. Just like that sorry excuse for an attorney, Grody Burger.
What? He punched me!
Well, Mr. Lawyer, what will you do, eh? Charge me with assault? Charge away, I welcome it, for it is you who will be found guilty.
What?
Heed my exposition. The police, the courts, they will do my bidding.
So you say. But I wonder, is that kind of control really possible?
I don't expect you to understand. It is a world beyond your comprehension. You came here from Grody Burgers, I presume?
Mr. Grossberg's, yes.
Then you must ask him, why is it that this painting of his hangs here? Perhaps then he will tell you. Perhaps he will explain how a man can live life purely for personal profit. Go now, skedaddle. There is nothing more to discuss.
Alright. Man punched me.
I don't remember his voice. I think it was like...
Oh. Huh? I don't think he's noticed me standing here. Maybe I should clear my throat?
Jumping Jehoshaphat!
Oh, you.
What's wrong? You look pensive. Like an old man at the end of his days.
I'm not senile yet. I was just thinking about this whole mess.
Something's really bothering him. That much is clear. Today's trial. So you came to see the trial?
Yes, I did. Something was bothering me all last night. You see, couldn't get a wink of sleep.
Really? What was that?
Well, you see, it's just... me and sister. Oh, poor girl. My boy, I owe you my thanks. Truly, I didn't know what I would have done if things had gone poorly for the girl.
Your refusal. As before, but why did you refuse her request for defense? I think I have a right to know.
A right, Mr. Wright? No, I'm sorry. It just, I need more time to think about it, my boy.
He does seem troubled about something. I'm starting to have a feeling I know what it is. So, I paid Blue Corp a visit.
Oh, I see.
Mr. Grossberg, I have to admit, something has been bothering me.
Oh, what is it? Well, out with it, my boy.
You see, it's just... that painting. Mr. Grossberg, sir. There was a giant painting hanging right there the other day, was there not? The one you said you had no intention of parting with. Well, I saw it. Today, it was in the CEO's office of Blue Corp, Red White's office.
Oh, you noticed. I suppose I should have guessed you would. It is a large painting. Mr. Grossberg.
Mr. Grossberg, I know you and Mr. White are somehow connected somehow.
Connected, you say?
Yes, and I know what it is. He's blackmailing you. Ha! You'll love it. Mr. White has something on you, doesn't he? Blackmail. I think that painting is fairly gaudy proof.
Very well. This may be the chance I've been waiting for. Maybe it's time to get this off my chest so I can finally rest easy again. After all, you are Mia's understudy. Perhaps it was fate.
What's he talking about?
Red White is a man who makes his living through intimidation. Blue Corp is a company that excels in finding people's weaknesses, I'm afraid. I've been paying them for 15 years now.
15 years?
Well, because of the DL6 incident, as you may have guessed.
The name on the back of those photographs.
As you suspect, I could not stand in defense of Maya because of this. Why, it would have destroyed me if I did.
So that's the connection.
It is hard for me to tell you this, my boy. My boy, but arresting Red White will be nigh on impossible.
Impossible? Why?
He has information on everyone. It gives him an iron grip. He owns judges, attorneys, prosecutors, police, and politicians.
What?
They are bound, unable to do harm to themselves, and therefore to him. Don't look at me like that. What you see is nothing more than the weight of many years.
Reason for blackmail. But why were you blackmailed over this, Mr. Grossberg?
The DL6 incident was top secret at the time. It made sense. The police didn't want people to know they were using a medium. They couldn't let people know, but one person found out. I told him.
You told White?
He offered me riches. It is an embarrassment to me now. Because I talked, the police were mocked far and wide. In secret, they began looking for the one who sold them out. Of course, White heard about it, and he came to me. Only this time, the offer was blackmail.
I see.
White controls the law of this country as he sees fit. Yet, if you would still challenge him, have a close look at Nia's office.
Nia's office?
She followed his every move for years. She maybe record something of what she found.
DL6 incident. What is the DL6 incident?
DL6 is nothing more than the sorting code that the police gave the case. It was 15 years ago now. I received a request from a medium. A spirit medium.
A medium?
Her name was Misty Fay.
Fay?
Indeed. She was Mia's mother. She had been investigating a murder in the bank request of the police, and she failed. As a result, the police called her a fraud.
This is what May was talking about the other day.
I did all I could for her, and in the end, cleared her of wrongdoing. The murder case, however, remains unsolved to this day. That case is the DL6 incident.
Right. Who to talk to now? Should we go and confront Blue Corp? Let's do that. Talk. Are we supposed to go? Present? Were we supposed to present something? don't know. What were we supposed to do?
Move?
Talk about the DL6 incident, yes? I don't know. Oh, Fane Kolorov's, that's where we're supposed to go. It's funny. Looking at this room, it seems some normal. Hard to imagine a murder took place here. Mr. Grossberg said there would be clues. Maybe I should have another look.
Where?
Down here. These are, that's not why I was pointing at Phoenix.
Maybe these?
All the cases of the chief works. Ever worked on are filed here. They're in alphabetical order. Let's take a look. Which file should I look at? What's his name? Red White. So A B C D E F G H I J K L M N O P Q R. So J to S. Let's see. J through S. Nothing much in here. Maybe I'll just skim some of this.
Skim.
Well, no harm in flipping through a bit, I guess. The biggest part's here, at the end of S. Suicide? Yeah. She has a collection of suicide reports. It's politicians, policemen. There's writing on most of these in pencil. White? This is Mia's handwriting. Wait, I get it. Mia thought this was involved in these suicides. White drove them all to it. I can use these newspaper clippings. Huh. Let's find the most disturbing one. Newspaper clipping added to the court record. Not sure how that can be helpful. Maybe we should go and talk to Mr. White. Blue Cop. There we are.
Well, or aren't you persistent?
Sorry, but there's something I have to ask you.
Mr. Lawyer, I really hate having to repeat myself. But it seems the message has not yet penetrated your thick skull, so stop bothering me. If you try my patience further, I fear a nasty accident may occur. Do I make myself clear?
Transparent. Present. Poop. Present. This is the only clue that Mia left me. I better make this one count. Mr. White, see this? It's an article describing the suicide of a politician. He was embezzling secret government funds. Then, one day, word got leaked to the press. The very next day, he took his own life.
And this concerns me how?
I found this article in Mia's office.
Miss Mia?
She had a file filled with articles like this. Every one of them was labeled with a single word. White. Mr. White, I know what you did to this politician.
You blackmailed him.
You were blackmailing him.
Blackmail?
Not just him, either. You were threatening and coercing hundreds of others. You were involved in all of the suicide cases that Mia investigated. This company is built on blackmail. I'm right, aren't I?
What is a bizarre accusation, Mr. Wrong? What is it that you should be doing now? Investigating me? No, I think not. You should be searching for the one who killed Miss Mia.
Secretary's office, hello?
Mr. Wrong will be leaving now.
Yes, sir. I'll send someone right away.
Wait a second. Mr. White.
You're wrong.
You're wrong, Mr. White.
Excuse me?
What I should be doing now is going after you.
What are you insinuating?
Mia was on to you. She was keeping tabs. For this reason, you had April May tapping her phone. Then, Mia was murdered, and all the documents about you mysteriously disappeared. So, the culprit would be... Even a child could work it out, Mr. White. You did it!
Secretary's office. We won't be needing an escort for Mr. Wrong. Instead, please connect me to the public prosecutor's office.
Of course, sir. One moment, please.
White, that you? What are you doing calling me at this time like this?
Hello, Chief Prosecutor? I've changed my mind. I want to testify tomorrow.
What's this about?
Mia Fey case. I've witnessed the murder, you see. And thus, as a very important witness, I would like to testify.
What? Why tomorrow? I thought you said you didn't want to go to court.
Quietitude. I told you I changed my mind, didn't I?
No, and one other thing. Send the police over here right away.
The man is standing right in front of me. He looks dazed, but could be violent.
What? What man?
Are you even listening? The executioner, the hatchet man, the liquidator, the killer man.
What? Mr. White, this isn't another one of those.
Chief Prosecutor, I did not believe you are in a position to freely offer your opinions to me, correct? I'm telling you to send the police now. Did I not tell you, Mr. Wrong? You are a mere lawyer, as was Miss Mia.
How dare you?
I'll point the finger at you, and you will be tried as Miss Mia's killer. This case is as good as settled. No lawyer of any worth will defend you. My friends in local lawyers' associations, you see. You'll be given a lawyer so stupendously inept that they make even you look competent.
I feel faint.
Detective Gumshoe, reporting, sir.
Ah, Butts. Harry Butts. Right, actually. Phoenix Wright. And my friend's name is Larry.
Oh, right. Sorry, pal. Butts was the murderer, right?
Detective Gumshoe, I present to you the man who killed Miss Mia Fey.
What?
Take this despicable human being into custody. Farewell, Mr. Wrong.
September 8th, 3:37 p.m. Detention Center. Visitor's Room.
I can't believe it's only been a day since the first trial. My trial begins tomorrow. White's going to set a trap for me. And the prosecutor will be on it, of course, Edgeworth included. An attorney was assigned to me by the state yesterday. I refused. I had an idea.
Wright! Mr. Wright!
Oh, Mayor. Great, they'll lay you out of detention.
Just now, yes, it's all thanks to you.
Now I'm afraid we switch places.
What? You mean, you?
I'll explain what happened to Mayor.
I don't believe it. How many people does that man need to destroy before he's satisfied? My mother, my sister, and now you. This has gone too far. Mr. Wright, please tell me, is there anything I can do?
Well... Femin Court, Chimmy on in court. How many break out of here? Chimmy on in court.
Well, you could cheer for me in court.
Cheer for you? You mean, like a cheerleader?
Yeah, like that. Alright, leave it to me.
Huh? Better go get a uniform and some pom-poms.
Wait.
What?
I'm kidding. It was a joke. No way.
No, really, I was kidding. But thanks. It's good to know you're on my side. There really isn't anything you can do for me anyway.
But I can't just sit here and do nothing. I've got to give that man a piece of my mind.
Just a piece? Okay. Then, come to the court tomorrow.
Okay. I'll be there.
I'll show them a thing or two.
It's the beginning of a new century. Yet, with crime, it's the same old story. In fact, it's gotten worse. Lengthy court proceedings are no longer realistic. Beginning a few years ago, a limit of 3 days was put on initial court trials. Almost all finished in the day, most with a guilty verdict. Never thought I would end up in the defendant's chair myself. Tomorrow, the true culprit will appear as a witness. This is it. It's me or him.
To be continued!
But, I want to carry on. This might be a bit long. Getting to the court scene, right now. I don't care. Let's do it. Wrap this case up in 2 episodes. I know the anime does it in 4 usually, or 3. But let's do it in 2 episodes, alright? Alright. September 9th, 9:52 a.m. District Court. Defendant Lobby. Number one.
Well, I guess this is it.
Yeah.
One way or another,
this case gets decided today.
Phoenix, look!
Prosecutor Edgeworth. I received a call from Public Prosecution's office yesterday.
Huh?
He told me that whatever Mr. White says today, it will be the absolute truth. No matter how you try to attack his testimony. If I raise an objection, I bet on good faith that the judge will listen to me.
What does White have the judge in his pocket too?
So, you're saying I'm going to be guilty? End of story? I'll do anything to get my verdict, Mr. Wright. Anything.
Why? How can you torment an innocent person like this?
Innocent? How can we know that? The guilty will always lie to avoid being found out. There's no way to tell who is guilty and who is innocent. All that I can hope to do is get every defendant declared guilty. So I make that my policy. Edgeworth, you've changed.
Hmm? Phoenix, you know him?
Don't expect any special treatment, Phoenix, right?
Phoenix?
Well, court will be opening for a session soon.
What? But wait! Your defense attorney isn't even here yet. He's not...
I'll be defending myself.
What?
Okay, let's do this. September 9th, 10 a.m. District Court, courtroom number 1.
The court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Phoenix Wright.
The prosecution is ready, Your Honor.
Defense is ready, Your Honor. Mr. Wright, are you sure you're up to doing this?
Yes, Your Honor. I'll be defending myself.
Understood. Very well. Mr. Edwards, your opening statement, please.
As the details of the event are already quite clear to the court, today we will hear the testimony of another witness to the defendant's crime.
I see. The prosecution may call its witness.
That went far too smoothly.
Why didn't the judge ask Edgeworth to...
Why his witness didn't testify before?
It's like he already knows why.
Then I was going to raise an objection about this. I suppose it's me.
Object.
Mr. Edgeworth, you owe an explanation to the court. Why didn't this witness testify in the trial against Miss Maya Fay?
I'm ever so sorry.
Mr. White is a busy man, and besides, at the time, I thought that Miss May's opinion was all that you would be needed. Again, my sincerest apologies to the court.
Excellent, Mr. Edgeworth. I appreciate your demeanor.
Great. He gets a show off, and I get nowhere.
I would like to call Mr. Red White to the stand.
Please state your full name.
You wish to know the title of my personage?
Your name?
Yes, that is what I said. Oh dear, do my locutions confuse?
Name! These two are great together.
My name is Red White, but my friend calls me Blanco Nino. I'm the CEO, or to use a more common term, the president of Blue Corp.
Did you know the victim, Miss Mia Fey?
That would be a negatory. No, I did not.
You're at the Gatewater Hotel the night of the murder.
Correct.
And you witnessed the murder from there.
Why tell you what you already know?
Very well, Mr. White. You may begin your testimony.
If I can't rip this guy's testimony apart, I'm done for. Why do I always feel like it's the end of the world and I'm the last man standing?
I hope you have made your peace with God, Mr. Lawyer.
Let him have it, Phoenix.
Witnesses count.
Let's see, it was about 9, I believe. I was quietly pacifying, that's reading to you some papers by the window. Then I heard a bedlam coming from the outside. Surprise, I turned to look at the building across the way. It was then I saw him, a spiky-haired man attacking a woman with long hair. Needless to say, that man was none other than you, Mr. Lawyer. I called Miss May over at once. She too was flabbergasted, of course. The victim, she ran away, but you gave chase. Finally, there was a terrible impaction. Then it was all over.
If things occurred as you testify, then I'm afraid the defendant is guilty.
Very well. Defendant? Mr. Wright. Your cross-examination.
Yes, Your Honor.
Cross-examination.
Well, he saw a man, and the other, although she was lying, was present.
Hold it!
How do you know what time it was?
Because I'm always absolutely perfect, you know.
No. You're not getting away with that.
You were so mistrusting, Mr. Lawyer. So, what was the proper term for secretary again? Anyway, Miss May ordered room service for 9. It happened soon after the room was serviced arise.
That's what Miss Mayer said too. Let's press further.
True, the bellboy who brought the coffee saw Miss May.
But he testified that he did not see you at the time.
This is your concern? Silly lawyer, Miss Makes received the coffee outside the room. Of course he could not see me. How would... he would need x-ray vision to pull off something like that.
Huh. Tell us, what were you doing at the time?
I was currently pacifying, that's reading to you, some papers.
We just gotta press everything.
By window, you mean the one directly across from the Fay & Co. law office? Correct. That is the only window you see.
And there were reading, and there you were, reading papers?
Correct. The Gatewater is a businessman's hotel, and I'm a businessman who had business to do. Then I heard a beadlem coming from outside.
This was a building. How? You were in a building, and there was a gap, and then I was in a building. How could you have heard me?
A bedlam? It must have been when you attacked, I assume.
We see. Continue.
No.
How?
Miz Odd saw us for a few moments before being hit.
May's the victim dodged an attack, then ran to the right, but she was caught and struck. But...
Can I view this?
Whatever. Wait, you must be able to view this. Check. Yeah, there we go. So, how could you have heard?
Objection!
Your Honor, what do you think about the witness's statement?
I'm not sure I follow.
It clearly contradicts the, I thought...
You don't sound very convinced, Mr. Wright.
Objection overruled.
Ugh. I don't think that won me any points with the judge. Then I heard a bedlam coming from outside. Surprised, I turned to look at the building across the way.
Hold it. So you're reading your papers until you heard that sound?
But of course, I'm no snoop peeping out of a windows at night.
No snoop? Yeah, right. You've made a career out of snooping.
It was then I saw him, a spiky-haired man attacking a woman with long hair.
Just gotta keep pressing him. Spiky-haired?
Needless to say, that man was none other than you, Mr. Lawyer.
Just keep pressing him. What you just said directly conflicts with Miss May's testimony. Miss May clearly stated that the assailant looked like a girl.
I've always been proud of my eyesight, Mr. Lawyer.
Just what is your eyesight? She's gonna say 20/20.
Counting both eyes, 40.
40? Don't add them together.
I think the witness is trying to say his eyesight is good.
Hey, those... Whose side is the judge on anyway?
And what did you do then? I called Miss May over at once. She too, of course, was surprised.
But she said she was already looking. What was Miss May doing at the time?
She had just finished watching a soap opera on the TV and was weeping openly.
Did you know she had been tapping the face?
Objection! Irrelevant. That has nothing to do with the case at hand. I care not. I will answer the lawyer's bold inquiry.
Miss May was acting alone when she tapped the phone of this fey woman. You'd make a good politician, Mr. White.
After all, I am El Presidente.
Please continue.
The victim, she ran away, but you gave chase.
Okay. Can you be a little more detailed about that? I think it's worth knowing exactly what happened.
Of course. Comprende. I understand. The victim was attacked by you and ran to the left. You gave chase and struck her down.
Are you sure?
As you know, I am always absolutely perfect. Perhaps you could change your testimony to reflect this new detail. The victim ran to the left.
But what's this?
Ran to the right.
Objection! Wait right there. Mr. White, you've dug your own grave.
What is this?
You said the victim ran to the left, but that directly contradicts Miss May's testimony. She clearly stated that the victim ran to the right.
Oh, it is simple. You have misheard her.
I think not. Look at the floor plans. The killer was here, and the victim here. If the victim ran to the left, as you claim she did, she would have been running directly away from the door. She would have been running into a dead end. Don't you find that odd?
Very strange.
I did see her run to the left. I did. Phoenix, look at his face. I don't think he's lying about this one. True. Maybe he really did see the victim run left. So he did witness the killing? Wait a second. Mr. Wright?
Yes, Your Honor.
Ms. May says right, and Mr. White says left. Can you explain this contradiction?
Yes, I can.
Both of them are right. Both witnesses are telling the truth, for once.
Huh, I doubt it.
Rather, that does not clear up the contradiction. There is one scenario that would explain the conflicting accounts.
What?
Obviously, the witness was not viewing the crime from the hotel.
Mr. Wright, what do you mean?
Yes, what do you mean? He was not viewing the crime from the hotel?
If he was not there in the hotel, where could he have been?
In the law offices of Fay & Co., of course. Well, specifically, he was standing here.
Show the court where Mr. White was standing.
The court where Mr. White was standing. If he was there, she ran that way, and if he's standing like that, then she's running to the right. Show the court where Mr. White was standing. I don't know, there.
Take that!
This is where he was. Look, when the victim ran for the door, if he was watching from this point, to him it would appear that she ran to the left.
Please, this is not time for jokes in ill taste. That is where the killer was standing.
Exactly my point, Mr. Edgeworth. Exactly my point.
Order. I will have order. Anyone disturbing the order of this court will be held in contempt.
Mr. Wright, what are you suggesting?
Rapscallion. Objection.
The postulations of defense are a distortion of the truth, Your Honor.
Indeed, they do seem a bit far-fetched. You approved us with so much entertainment, Mr. Lawyer.
What now? He's laughing?
The hilarity of the moment made me remember something. It appears I've been unclear, and for this, I apologize. Mr. Your Honor, might I be allowed to testify once more?
Very well. Let's hear your revised testimony. Good luck. You can't fix a broken testimony, buddy. She ran to the left.
Miss May's testimony was correct, as was mine. When you assaulted the girl, she first ran to the left, and then you hit her savagely. That is what I saw. Next, with the last of her strength, she ran to the right. You chased her and delivered the final blow.
That is what Miss May saw.
You see, you hit her twice. Don't you remember, Mr. Lawyer?
I hit her twice. Does that seem to make more sense? Will you be cross-examining the witness's testimony?
You bet I will. I mean, yes, Your Honor.
She ran to the left. Well, if we look at this here, her autopsy report, vulnerable blunt object, she may live for a few minutes before being hit. For a few minutes after being hit. Doesn't say she was hit once. But it does say she was hit. Okay. When you assaulted the girl, she first ran to the left. Hold it.
What do you mean, first?
First? That is what comes before what happens next.
You do speak English, right? Please, sit back, relax. I will try to simple words for your benefit. First, she ran to the left, and then?
And then you hit her, savagely. That is what I saw. I didn't hit anyone.
Now, Mr. Wright, there is no point hiding things from this court.
I'm not hiding anything!
Objection!
The prosecution requests that the defense refrain from interrupting the testimony.
Mr. Wright, you've been warned.
Why is he mad at me?
Next, the last of her strength, she ran to the right.
I present her autopsy report.
Objection! Mr. White, the victim died from a single blow. What do you have to say to that?
Now's my chance to hit it where it counts.
Mr. White, wasn't it you who told this court you were absolutely perfect?
Music's a bit laggy.
I will refrain from using this phrase from now on. Your Honor, if you could ask the witness for a new testimony. Objection! The witness is obviously confused, Your Honor. I would like to request a 10-minute break.
Yes, yes, quite.
Objection! The witness is confused because he's lying! I empathetically request that there be no break, Your Honor!
Yeah, we want justice! Don't let him get away!
Very well. If the witness would care to revise his testimony. Crowd's on my side. No slipping out of this one now, White.
Mr. White?
Okay.
The two accounts.
Well, see, I looked at the other window when I heard the thing fall.
What thing?
Then, the next moment, I saw Miss Mia run to the left. The killer, you know, attacked her, but she dodged. And then she turned and ran for the door. Then you did her in with a single blow. Thwop.
Thwop indeed. Very well, you may begin your cross-examination.
Mr. Your Honor, my stomach, you see, it is hurting.
Deal with it. This is almost over.
The two accounts. Well, I looked at the other window when I heard that thing fall.
Hold it. You heard that thing fall? What exactly was that thing?
Huh? Well, oh, that, the glass light stand.
Right, the one that had fallen over at the scene.
Phoenix! Doesn't something about strike you as odd?
Yeah, very odd. That is odd. I'll press further.
Mr. White.
Huh? What?
You're saying that you saw the glass light stand?
Yes.
Then change your testimony to reflect that.
Sorry, my bad.
The witness will revise his testimony.
Again?
Of course.
Light stand was lying on the floor when I looked.
I want to check something.
Check. See, this is the field of view. He couldn't have seen the light stand, as it's there. If it fell over, he couldn't have seen it.
Objection!
Mr. White! It was impossible for you to have seen the glass light stand.
What?
Look at this. These are the floor plans to the scene of the murder, yes? Correct, Your Honor. Now, look. If you were to look through the window at the office, this is the area you'd be able to see. Here. Well?
Now that the stand is not within the visible area.
Well, Mr. White?
What do you have to say to that?
Ridiculosity. Mr. White, if you were in the Gatewater Hotel as you claim, you could not have seen the stand before it fell over. In fact, you wouldn't have been able to see it after it fell over either. There's no way you could have recognized the broken shards of glass as a light stand. So, when did you see the stand, Mr. White? It must have been the moment that it fell, and the only place you could have seen that from is inside the Fay Law offices. In other words, you were at the scene of the crime when the murder took place.
I think we got him.
Mr. White?
Mr. White. You did it, didn't you?
Mr. Your Honor, I, Miss Mia.
Looks like we're about to get our verdict.
Objection! That's far enough, Phoenix Wright.
What?
I forgot about Edgeworth. Mr. White, I think the time has come. Shouldn't you confess your crime now?
Hmm? What?
I said you should confess your crime. Ergo, confess that you placed the wiretap.
The wiretap?
Order, order. Mr. Edgeworth, explain to the court what you mean by this.
Distinguished members of the court, Mr. White is slightly confused. Allow me to explain. I really don't like the way this is headed. As you know, Mr. White is the CEO of Blue Corp. He ordered his secretary, Miss April May, to take the law offices of Miss May. What does that have to do,
Your Honor?
The question is, when was the wiretap placed in the office, and by who?
No, you wouldn't.
Mr. White, in order to place the wiretap, you entered Miss Fay's office. Am I correct?
Correct. You are most correct, Miles.
Give me a break.
Yes, in order to place the wiretap, I breached the Fay & Co. law offices. That is when I saw that accursed light stand.
Now I'm confused. Please explain to the court what all this means, Mr. Edgeworth.
Gladly, Your Honor. Mr. Phoenix Wright has made his position quite clear. He has determined that Mr. White knew the glass stand was in the office. He has shown that there was only one time Mr. White could have seen the stand, at the very moment of the murder. Thus, Mr. Wright would like you to believe that Mr. White was the murderer.
I see. However,
it is a fact that Mr. White had been in that office well before the murder took place. He went to place the wiretap. He could have seen the glass stand light stand then.
Ergo, Mr. Phoenix Wright's theory is revealed for the basis conjecture it is.
English. I need to get better at English.
Mr. White, you will testify to the court about this wiretap.
Leave it to me.
I feel faint.
Witness testimony. The wiretapping.
It was the beginning of September, the week before the murder. I'd entered the Fay & Co. law offices. Of course, I'd done so to place the wiretap. That is when I saw this glass light stand.
Is that all? So, you saw the stand before the night of the incident, and this is how you were able to identify what had fallen over, by the sound?
Correct. That is right.
I see. Very well. Mr. Wright, you may cross-examine. What am I supposed to do now?
Good luck, Phoenix.
Alright, we'll press him for every detail.
It was the beginning of September, the week before the murder.
Let's look at some evidence here.
Not what I was supposed to look for. Found at Miss May's hotel room. What's this? Okay. I don't know, just look at some evidence. It's always nice to look at evidence.
Hold it! Just gotta look. Press him. Did you have proof? Objection! Miss April May knew the details of Miss Fay's phone conversation. This proves that the wiretap was placed before the murder.
Right.
I'd entered the Fay & Co. law offices.
No, just gotta press him for everything, man. Was it really you that went into the office, or was it Miss May? Objection! Unidentified fingerprints several days old were found in the Fay & Co. law office. Those were obviously Mr. White's. And if I know Edgeworth, he's already run a check on those prints. Now, Mr. White, tell us why you went to the Fay & Co. law offices.
Of course, I had done so to place the wiretap.
Keep pressing it, ma'am. Why did you tap Miss Mayer's phone? Objection! This has no bearing on the current case, Your Honor.
Blue Corp is a detective agency of sorts. We have a responsibility to protect client confidentiality. That is when I saw this glass light stand.
Hold it! Let's go. Keep pressing it, man. Why did you notice something as innocuous as a light stand?
The light stand was made entirely out of glass. It was quite stylish, so I guess it made a lasting impression on me. Such a beautiful thing deserves attention, does it not? That is all.
Damn it! There's nothing there for me to press him on.
Oh well. Maybe he's rattled enough that I can bluff him out something. It was the beginning of September, the week before the murder.
I don't know, man. What have we got to look through?
Die from a blunt who may have been looking for the hit. What's the conversation between the chief and mayor? Touch the check button to listen. Already listened to it, don't need to. The broken remains of glass light stand broken beyond all recognition. Clock in the form of a statue. Miss Mayor's hotel room. Department store received with letters put in blood and back. The victim dodged an attack, then ran to the right, or she was caught struck.
I don't know. Maybe I could listen to this.
You haven't called in a while, actually. There's something I wish to tell you. What is it this time? It's a clock. It's made to look such a thinker, blah blah blah. I tell you, the clock isn't talking right now. What's wrong? It's last thing. Blah blah blah. Pips that was okay. I don't know what to do. We gotta keep pressing him stuff. Let's look at the floor plans. Let's thank all the horses. Glass light stand. Where was the wiretap? We don't know where it was placed. It's found next to the bush. The phone was found next to the bush. We just keep presenting things. Your Honor, what do you think? Blah, it's wrong. Come on. Clearly contradicts the, I thought. Come on. So I'm very convinced, Mr. Wright. Objection overruled. Don't think that won me any points for the judge. Beginning of September, the week before the murder. And enter the phone called law offices. Of course, I had done so to place the wiretap. Don't tell me, I've run out of ammo. I'm afraid that's as far as you go, Mr. Wright. The time has come for you to admit your defeat. You fought honorably. No more. I can't take this anymore. Mr. Wright, are you giving up? Yes, Your Honor. Phoenix! Phoenix, over here! I know that voice. Oh, it's... Mia? Never give up, Phoenix. Mia! Phoenix passed out. Yeah, it's fun. Where am I? The waiting lobby? What happened? Oh, right. I lost the trial. I was hallucinating. Ah, you're finally awake. Hey, Phoenix! That's no way to greet an old friend. Phoenix, I want you to look at me. You're... Maya? Didn't you know that the Fae women have strong psychic powers? When you accepted your defeat in court, it appears that that was enough of a shock to awaken Maya's true powers. So, Maya's telling you, Mia? That's right. I am Maya, but I'm also Mia. Now, I want you to listen to me, Phoenix. Maya never gave up. You can either. That's what I came here to tell you. But we don't have much time, Phoenix. Now listen. You've already won. Huh? You have that receipt in the court record, right? Yeah. The one you wrote Maya on. Phoenix. Wait, wrote that note, not me. So what did I do with it? Look at the front of the receipt. The front? It's a regular receipt. Looks like it's from a famous department store. $1,000. That's a lot. Wow, big spender. Item, glass light stand. Date of purchase, September 4th. September 4th? That's right, Phoenix. I brought this stand the day before I was killed. Now, what did Mr. White say in his testimony? It was the beginning of September, the week before the murder. He said he saw the stand the week before the murder. There you go. I think the court is about to reconvene. Go do it, Phoenix. You know you're innocent, now just have to prove it. Right. See, updated in the court record. So I guess we had to lose that? I don't know. September 9, 1:16 p.m. District Court, courtroom number 1. The court will now reconvene for the trial of Mr. Phoenix Wright. Is the defendant rather... Are you alright, Mr. Wright? Yeah, sorry, Your Honor. I'm fine now. Then, let's start where we left off. Your Honor, there is nothing to go back to. The cross-examination of Mr. White is finished. All that is required now is for you to pass judgment on the defendant, Mr. Phoenix Wright. Your Honor, please, give me one more chance. I promise you, this is the last time I'll ask you. But, as Mr. Edgeworth has noted, the trial is more or less finished. Mr. Edgeworth, do you have an opinion on this matter? I say, let us give Mr. Phoenix Wright his last chance. Very well. We may begin your cross-examination. Right. It was the beginning of September, the week before the murder.
No, I don't think so, buddy.
Objection! Look closely at this. You see the word mayor written in blood? No grasping.
I think not. Look at the other side of the receipt.
The other side?
Your Honor, would you tell the court what is written on the other side of that receipt?
Well, a glass light stand. And the date of the purchase? Why, that's the day before the murder.
You see? Mr. White, when you allegedly entered Fay and Cole offices at the beginning of September, the stand could not have been there.
Well, Mr. White, can't get out of this one, can you?
No, it's impossible.
Uh-oh, he's losing it. Well, Your Honor, I understand there must be quite a bit of pressure on you.
But I think you'll agree, can't judge me guilty under these circumstances.
Very well. Then, that is all for the trial of.
Objection!
What are you gonna say, Edgeworth?
Not so fast. Phoenix Wright?
What?
No way can he worm his way out of this one.
Oh wait, I forgot.
It's Edgeworth.
There is a certain thread of logic to the defendant's claims.
However, there is no concrete proof that Phoenix Wright is innocent.
Ergo,
I would like to request one more day before Phoenix Wright is granted his freedom. I need time to make one more inquiry into this matter.
Another inquiry? This isn't going to be another one of those updated autopsy reports. This guy just makes up evidence as he pleases.
This is bad. Object.
Mr. White's guilt is obvious. There is no need to proceed this trial any further.
Well, Mr. Edgeworth,
if anyone was going to call Mr. White to trial, it would be me and the prosecutor. I need a day to ascertain whether your claims have any evidence.
I see. Objection denied.
What?
The completion of the trial, Mr. Phoenix Wright, will be postponed until tomorrow.
No! There's no telling what will happen if I can't end this now. Edgeworth is sure to come up with, or just make up something.
And after Mia showed up to help me and all.
Mr. Your Honor, may I go home?
Of course. Thank you for your time.
Well, the witness will stay! Mia! Phoenix! Read this note out loud.
Mia?
What's this?
Memo received from Mia.
Your Honor, if I may?
You're quite persistent today, Mr. Wright.
You bet I am. My life is riding on this one.
I have something I would like to read to this court.
List of names Mia in them.
Take that!
The memo Mia had given me was a list of names. Many of them sounded strangely familiar. People in finance. Famous celebrities. That's when it happened.
Stop! Desist! Halt! Please, stop! Make him stop! How did you get that list?
Mr. White, admit your guilt. Then here, right now. Or else this list will be released to the press.
I confess. I did it. I hit her. I hit Miss Mia Fey with the thinker.
Case closed, Your Honor.
Well, I see no reason to continue this trial. Mr. Wright?
Yes, Your Honor.
You've done it again. That was quite a spirited defense.
Yes, Your Honor. Guess you could say that. If only you knew how spirited it was.
Well, this court finds the defense, the defendant, Mr. Phoenix Wright, not guilty! That is all. The court is adjourned.
September 9th, 2:24 p.m. District Court, Defense Lobby Number 1.
Well, I never thought I'd be saying this again, but congratulations.
You're lucky I was born a fae. I'm lucky I had both you and Mayor on my side.
I'm glad you made it.
Thank you, Phoenix. You're so glad to help me, and Maya. I won't forget it as long as I live.
As long as you live?
My time here is running out.
Maya's powers are still weak. I can't stay here that long.
Wait, no! There's still so much to say.
Don't worry. I'm sure we'll meet again.
Chief! I'm not the chief anymore.
Phoenix, can you come to the office tonight, say, 9?
The office?
I'll see you later.
Chief! Maya!
I guess that's what you gotta do.
November 9, 9:02 p.m. Fane Co-Law offices.
Being here, it's hard not to think about that night.
You came!
Maya.
I was kinda worried you might not.
Huh? Of course I came.
Well then,
I'm pretty hungry. How about a burger? Maya?
You should see your face.
Maya!
What are you talking about? It's me, Maya.
Maya?
What, did I look like my sister?
Look like? You were her.
I might be able to use that. Oh, Phoenix, go to the store and buy me lunch, would you?
Maya? Why are you here?
Because of this. See? Maya wrote me a letter. Take care of Phoenix for me.
Take care of...
Huh? See? She means the office. This office. Someone has to help with the new Wright and Co. law offices, right? And who better but me, Maya Faye, reporting for duty. Wait, no. On second thought, let's make this casual.
Yo, Nick, Maya here. Ready to get down to business.
You don't
mind me calling you Nick, do you?
It's a great name. Maya said that's what your friend Larry calls you.
Nick.
You know what this means? We're partners.
You know, when I think about it, it is Maya's fault I'm here now. But it isn't. If it wasn't for her, I'd probably be in jail. Right in Cole offices. Got a good ring to her.
Yeah. Thanks, Maya.
Good luck, Phoenix. I'll always be here, watching you.
Just watching. I read that wrong.
Right. Okay, Nick. Let's do this.
Huh? Do what?
Burgers, dummy. Burgers. There's a great burger joint down the street. Come on. Time's a-wasting.
Okay. Wait up.
The end.
Nah, Phoenix, right. Episode has been added. Turnabout Samurai.
Nah, pretty nice.
Well, might click. There we are. Save up to this point. Yes. Saving. Thank you. Well, what did we do? We cleared Maya's name, we cleared our own name, and we put the right man in prison. Next time on Phoenix Wright, we're gonna carry on to Turnabout Samurai. See ya!